It's Malcolm. Malcolm Watson. Malcolm Watson. And I play the violin. Violin. It's an electric violin. Would you like to hear some? Come with me. I started learning when I was about 7.
My uncle gave me a beautiful little violin.
And it must have been about that big, if I remember rightly.
I'm Tristan. I'm 7 years old. This is my dad. My dad is a musician too.
I want you to meet a talent of the first order.
I was actually playing concert performances by the age of about 10. I went through and did the Royal Academy from the age of 16 to 20. And there I met up with an American and we did our own original music. And we were in Paris, out in the streets. I enjoyed that a lot.
Shall we dance?
I'd love to, but don't you think we'd better wait until the music starts?
I really like to dance when I play my violin, which is a bit unusual, I know. It's just another art form.
Violin is always supposed to stand there very stuck and rooted to the ground, but I don't have to be, you know, I can dance.
And I find it really helps me express myself lots more, especially with my bare feet, because I can dance right to the end of my toes.
If I was an instrument, what instrument would I be?
This particular violin was made in Italy. Nearly 100 years ago in a little village called Crotona. I'm sure you know what these are. These are the strings. And they come out of this top bit here, which is called the scroll.
This is a snare.
And then the strings come down.
These are the wires, so when you hit the snare, they vibrate.
Go over this little thin piece of wood, which is called a bridge.
Ride cymbal.
And then the sound goes down inside the body, which is like a hollow box.
This is a tom-tom.
And then the sound comes out of these holes that they called F holes.
And these are the sticks.
And this is the bow. It's actually a bit like you use for bows and arrows. The string here is actually horse's hair. And it comes from the tail. This is a real different looking violin, isn't it? This is a solid violin. I call it the anchor. Can anybody guess why? This one gets its sound because it's electric. It has a bridge like the other violin, but this one has lots of microphones which take the sound and amplify it.
This demo is a box with some elastic bands, and it's amazing, the tonality, it really rings. And you can actually see when you pull and pluck the elastic band, the actual string waves like a wave.
Excellent!
people can get a little bit too serious about classical music.
Rock and roll!
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock.
Just let me rock and roll, rock it is just roll. So passionate, it's so intensely and so on the edge.
You know how it is, rocking and rolling.
And fascinatingly enough, this is an arena that classical music also had 200 or 300 years ago. There's lots of room for free improvisation. Paganini lived in the late 17, early 1800s. He was considered an absolute genius. He was the Hendrix of his day. People would flock to his concerts. Paganini was a quite outrageous fellow. If he saw some people not paying attention, he would actually start to play farmyard noises. Make it sound like a cow or a duck. And make all of these crazy, insane noises on his violin.
Sounds kind of interesting.
And then just turn around and walk off the stage. Math is very, very close to music. It's amazing how few people really know that.
Well, that's cool, baby.
Folk music has always affected very strongly, I think, the mainstream of music. A group like the Beatles actually would take ethnic sounds from different countries and weave it into their music.
Lovely, wasn't it? Definitely no jazz. No jazz.
The whole arena of jazz really came up through folk music of Africa. Even the great classical composers like Brahms and Beethoven, how you can hear in their music, the folk tune is obviously caught their fancy and they've taken it and woven it into their bigger composition. What I would like to see people getting out of this show is life is to be lived to the fullest, that they'll feel more in contact with themselves. And I'm hopeful that they will have more appreciation and interest in music and the arts.